It's been a great season.
Fighters off!
Hang
on! It's
you in
the finish line!
Close! Close!
Come on! You're pulling back a little bit!
Your head! Your head!
Come on, your mantra!
We have no losers in this family!
Come in, she's around here somewhere.
What's for dinner? I don't suppose you've kept it warm.
And I don't suppose...
No, no, don't worry. It's no trouble.
Look at the dishes.
Hello? Where are you? Where have you...
This airplane thing. It's been proven already. The theory itself has been proven already, but when applying it to an actual aircraft, it just doesn't... There's no additional lift. And I don't see why. I'm on my fifth proof, and, well... There's a mistake. I've made a mistake, and I can't seem to find it. It's driving me to the birds, really. You see, if you know the behavior of the fluid flow in the vicinity of an airfoil, which of course I do, then the principle could be used to calculate the lift force of said airfoil, air being fluid at transit, of course. If the air flowing past the top surface of an aircraft wing is moving faster than the air flowing past the bottom surface, then the principle implies that the pressure on the surfaces of the wing will be lower above than below. The pressure difference results in an upward lift force. So my wing is flat. Flat on the top. Flat on the bottom with a hump in the middle. Flat on the top, flat on the bottom, hump in the middle. Creating an even longer path for the air to travel, resulting in additional lift. Well, it doesn't. In actuality, it rather waddles. Something akin to a spiral frame duck.